come in here and do some delicious pork sliders. And yes, that's coming soon. I will be cooking on that Big Mama very soon. But today, we are going to take a ride in the RT700 Bull. It's never let me down. A little teabag action there for ya. We're going to cook some delicious pork. But first, we got to fill up that hopper with these delicious Bear Mountain pellets. Oak. Smooth, smoky flavor. A little bit more of that teabag action for ya. We're going to turn this cooker on and make sure that it rocks 225 today. It's about 5:30 p.m. We've got that sweet Texas heat rub from local HEB and also their salt and pepper blend. I'm going to sip on a Pitmaster in my little Rectech koozie. And here's my knife. Guys, this is going to be the easiest cook that I've ever done. I'm not going to do much. We've got a pork butt here and a delicious pork belly. Okay. I'm going to use one rub on each one of these proteins here. Just going to crack them open. I'm not even going to trim anything. I'm just going to season it and put it on the cooker. So on the pork belly, I'm going to do the salt and pepper blend only. And on the pork butt, I'm going to use that Texas Sweet Heat. And both of these rubs you can find at my local HEB, at your local HEB. Delicious rubs there. And now the pit's up to temp, and got my second rack in there just because, no particular reason, but just gonna put the belly in it, and then the pork butt right there. And I guess I probably should have removed that upper rack because it kind of scalped some of the seasoning when I put it in the cooker, but it's okay. Beautiful color off of that rub, and we're gonna go overnight, guys. 225, wide open. And that's the internal temps on the proteins the next morning. This is Saturday morning. The pork belly is sitting at 190. And the pork butt is sitting closer to the 170. But I'm just gonna wrap the pork butt to finish it off. I never wrap my pork bellies. I just let them cook wide open until I hit that internal temp of like 203. Anywhere between 202 to 205, I pull the pork butt, the pork belly. But look at that beautiful color. Nice mahogany. That Texas Sweet Heat from HEB is something else. Just take a look at that color that it's dropping here. I'm just going to add just a little bit more rub to it before wrapping it. And I'm just going to wrap it in two layers and put it back in the cooker. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and check that the pork belly. And we're done on this pork belly. Got 200 here, rocking 205, so we're completely done with this thing. I'm just going to go ahead and pull it, and look at that beautiful pork belly, guys. Oh man, this thing. I'm just going to wrap it in some foil, and there's you some close-up on that delicious barkiness that it built on that overnight cook. 225. Pork belly was done around 8 a.m. the next morning. And there's your another close-up shot on that beautiful bark that it created. This thing is just filled with so much moisture. And that fat just created kind of like a cocoon of deliciousness on that inside. And here we are. This is about 5 hours later. I'm going to go ahead and take the nastiness off of the pork butt. All that non-edible ooey gooey stuff that you don't want to eat. I don't want to feed my family that stuff. I'm just going to remove it. The one thing I did enjoy about this Texas Sweet Heat, there's your close-up of that delicious meat. is that I did not have to add any seasoning to it after I pulled it all apart. It was great just the way that it was. You see that liquid that pulled down at the bottom? I just kind of poured it over the top. Over the top of it. So here I am chopping it up. I enjoy pulled pork, but I like eating it better when I chop it. It's just easier to eat, and you get a better bite, and you can honestly make more sandwiches out of it. I think it gets more flavor that way as well. And on that pork belly, look at that deliciousness. I had to taste it. Amazing, guys. Salt pepper blend from H-E-B. Nice barky goodness. Look at the meat on that stuff. Came on very, very tasty. I'm also removing non-edible fat off that as I'm chopping it. And a couple of spots that had quite a bit, but for the most part, it was pretty good. Pretty good pork belly. And what I like to do is just mix it all together, mix both cuts all together, and make my sandwiches out of that. And that's the finished product. I mean, look at that beautiful porky goodness. I didn't have to add any extra seasoning. You know, both rubs combined, and you know, with both proteins, it was just fantastic. It was delicious. Made a whole bunch of little sliders and some big sandwiches. We couldn't even finish this stuff. I actually vacuum sealed it and put it in the freezer. But here's a couple of Gabrick BBQ sauces that people could use if they chose to. I personally did not on these sandwiches. I just put some onions and some banana peppers in it, and I was good to go. Ate it with some chips. Washed it down with a nice cold beverage, and it was a great cook, guys. It was delicious. What can I say? I mean, just take a look at that. Will not be the last time I use these rubs, guys. I appreciate you guys watching. We'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.